Hi, my name is Hannah Hemmelgarn. I'm the Assistant Program Director here at the Center for Agroforestry at MU. And today I am at the Horticulture and Agroforestry Research Center. What I'm standing in front of here is a little forested patch near the office where we have a small demonstration area of forest farming. And the forest farming practice, this is one of the recognized temperate agroforestry practices that includes the cultivation or propagation and harvest of what's called non-timber forest products, or NTFPs. I like to think of these as beyond timber forest products. Most common NTFPs are mushrooms, culinary and medicinal mushrooms. They can include forest botanicals for sale as value-added products or for wholesale, typically as roots, root products. But certainly other parts of these forest botanicals can be harvested. But NTFPs are inclusive of all kinds of plants and fungus and other decorative items that come from a forest. So around here, we'll check out a couple examples, including reishi mushrooms and goldenseal leaves when we go in. But we're also standing here in front of a really nice patch of jewelweed, or impatiens capensis. And jewelweed this time of year has these lovely little orange flowers that stand out. And I think of jewelweed as being a great friend for addressing poison ivy or other skin rashes. So we often see jewelweed and poison ivy in the same spaces. And jewelweed is one of many plants that grows wild around here in Missouri that can be harvested and prepared as a salve or as an oil, and then sold as a value-added product as an NTFP, or a non-timber forest product. So let's go into the forest and check out some other examples. All right, so we came just inside this nice shady forested area, which is where we have propagated some goldenseal roots. And we always like to mark them with a little orange flag so we don't lose track of them, because these plants take a while to get established and to grow to maturity. So what I'm looking at here is goldenseal. And goldenseal, the name is reflective of the beautiful golden roots of this plant. And they're really high in berberine, an alkaloid that gives them their medicinal effect. And they are useful for all kinds of remedies. But goldenseal is one of these plants that's important to us as a forest botanical and forest farming practices, in part because they're not very common anymore. They've been over-harvested, they're valuable for their roots, and because the roots are dug to be sold, these plants don't often have a chance to make sure that they're regenerating on their own. So there are a few practices that you can do to make sure that the plants that you do dig, whether they're wild or cultivated, have a chance to ensure that their populations are stable. One of those practices is to harvest the roots in the beginning part of fall. So you do that when you can still see the leaves. They might be starting to turn yellow, but after they have gone to fruit. So after you'll see the bright red clusters of berries. Usually it takes a few years for a goldenseal plant to start producing berries. But after you see that those berries have dropped, or after you've planted them intentionally, then, you know, around September, October is when you might come in this area to harvest roots when they are mature. And we can pull up one of these roots to check it out so you can see what those look like, since we're just about in the time for that to start happening in here in Missouri. But one other thing I want to point out as we're looking at these leaves, while they're still green, after they have produced those berries, after they've gone through that part of their life cycle, you can also harvest a leaf. So the leaves, especially these nice big leaves, while they're still green and beautiful, if there's a plant that has multiple leaves, you can sustainably harvest just a couple of one or two of those for each plant, dry them, and then sell them, package them and sell them as a tea. Also has great medicinal benefits and is a more sustainable annual way that you can be harvesting from this plant and selling a non-timber forest product without removing the whole plant and its root. So let's check this out. Let's dig up a little part of this and see what these roots look like. All right, so here you can see those beautiful golden roots with that berberine alkaloid. And Goldenseal is one that is fairly easy to propagate from the roots. So you'll see some places on this root where there is a little circular area, that's the seal of the Goldenseal, that marks each year that this plant has been in the ground. And there are also little nodules of new growth where we can see there will be another shoot and leaf coming up next year. So when propagating these, and this is a fairly small piece, so I'm not going to cut this for this year, but when propagating these, you can cut just maybe an inch or so of the root with some of these finer root hairs and root pieces, and then making sure that there's one of those little growth, new growth nodules, and then divide those, put them in new places, and you'll have two plants from one. So that is the beauty of Goldenseal and these beautiful leaves. There are some lookalikes of Goldenseal, or plants that get confused with Goldenseal. One of them is right next to these plants. This is Virginia creeper. And you can see some of the differences between these leaves, especially when they're right next to each other. They do have, you know, similar sort of palmate shape, but of course, Virginia creeper, these leaves are all on separate stems here. Well, they're on the same stem. But separated, whereas Goldenseal is entire. Another example of a medicinal non-timber forest product is reishi mushrooms. So these reishis have been here for a few years, these logs. We inoculated these logs with the mycelium spawn for reishi so that we could be sure that these are the mushrooms we're harvesting from this area. And you can see they have this beautiful, distinct orange, sort of amber orange color. And these are another one that can be sold as a product on their own or turned into a value-added medicinal product. So you can see just the distinct character of these Ganoderma reishi mushrooms with that brighter yellow underside and the sort of shiny, hard, darker orange top. And these are a fairly firm mushroom. They're not edible. They're not for eating. They are medicinal and have wonderful benefits that are most known in the eastern parts of the world. A couple of my favorite resources on this subject are these two books, Farming the Woods by Ken Mudge and Steve Gabriel, and Growing and Marketing Ginseng, Goldenseal, and Other Woodland Medicinals by Janine Davis and W. Scott Persons. Thanks for tuning in as we explore a couple of these non-timber forest product options for a forest farming practice. Be sure to subscribe to Mizzou Agroforestry and some of our other social media at MU Agroforestry so you can continue learning about other options for forest botanicals, fungi, and other decorative and medicinal and edible forest products. See you next time.